of niche broadcasting. Never let it be said that ESPN is unmindful of the demographic changes sweeping the country. If Poland's political parties can campaign here for the expatriate vote, there's no reason we can't cater to a growing minority via their glorious sporting history. And if their glorious sporting history happens to come at England's expense, then it can only be good for the viewing figures in Ireland, Scotland and Wales. Throw in some English masochists and, you know, the advertisers should be happy. Anyway, if you haven't guessed what's coming up, it's England versus Poland in the 1974 World Cup qualifier at Wembley. England have to win, Poland just need a draw.
The England team is the winning side from the last international here. Martin Peters leading the 11, which put 7 goals past Austria. The 5 substitutes, of whom 2 can be used, are Ray Clements, Peter Storey, Bobby Moore, Kevin Keegan and the uncapped Kevin Hector. For the record, this is the 28th international that England have played since being knocked out of the last World Cup in Lyon. And in that time, Sir Alf Ramsey has awarded 23 new caps. The Polish team playing tonight in red shirts and red shorts is also unchanged, so it's the lineup which beat Wales 3-0 last month and drew 1-1 in Rotterdam against Holland last week. 3 members of Stal Mielec, the champions, are included, and 5 from the Olympic squad, but of course no Lubanski. Lato, the top scorer in Polish football last season, is the most interesting and perhaps the most dangerous of those who didn't play in Poland's 2-0 defeat of England in Katowice last June. The atmosphere here at Wembley, arguably more gripping than at the 1966 World Cup final. But then floodlights always heighten the tension, and there's plenty of that tonight. Crowd in very good voice indeed. Which is, of course, what Sir Alf Ramsey has asked, if not pleaded for. On the right are the Polish manager and his assistant, on the left the England substitutes. The referee is Vital Loro of Belgium, and he's accompanied by 2 linesmen from the same country, Pierre Boutet and Jan Peters. Win or bust, the England team and their crowd are at one in the knowledge of what has to be achieved, and it is to be hoped that each will be able to help the other. Shannon. Clark, and the first free kick of the match is against Szymanowski. England have pushed 3 players into the 18-yard area. Bell number 4, Shannon number 8, Chivers number 9, and Clark now joining them. And Chivers! Didn't pick him up terribly well, but it ran away from him to the keeper, who almost lost it to Clark. And Tomaszewski's gone down injured. Well, got a kick on the hand. Skodaka. Musial's pass going loose. Tomaszewski shaken up right at the start, but it was his own fault. He still wants attention, but the referee has started play again, and Dana, the Polish captain, complaining to him. Chivers in the middle, so is Clark, so is Peters! Didn't get it right. England, though, have got to keep their cool as these chances come up and are not put away. 2 Poles, though, just lurking in attacking positions for the break. It's a good break by Dana. Too long though for Domaski. Hunter. Shannon, very much the focal point at the moment. Chivers. Bit of a gift that. The big fellow at the back. Smikiewicz. Domaski. Lato. No problem. Shannon. Chivers to his left. Shannon again driving at the defence and brought down by Buzek. Being shown. And the name of Mirosław Bozacki going in the notebook of the referee. Tomaszewski checking the left-hand post. Peterson carry on the wall. Bell just to the right. McFarland is up on the left. Look at the tension as the players coming, trying to come forward. McFarland! Shannon! Off the line! McFarland reaching for it and Shannon just unable to push it home. Domaski. Good play there by McFarland. It looked as though he wasn't going to be able to make that cross ball. Dana. So far making his passes in an area where England won't be too worried about it. Curry certainly put him under pressure. Mushal, Kasprzak, Mushal again, a little bit long. Hughes, Peters has moved up on the right, number 11, Clark on the far side, so is Chivers now coming across the box. There's Clark, didn't know that Shannon was behind him. Shannon was coming in then. Across by Peters. Look at Clark trying to get back and got right in Shannon's way. Kronowski, Smikiewicz. Crowd certainly playing their part. Shannon, and so is he. Chivers, Bozacki at his back. Hunter, McFarland, Curry is wide to the right. Maidley. That's for Chivers. Clark, if he can turn. Chivers found himself a bit of room to take the cross. Clark just couldn't work his way through the legs. Made this cross. Chivers winning it in the air. Clark just couldn't turn around the big fellow Gorgon. It's McFarland. Blocked by Mushal. Curry. Oh, and that could so easily have gone in by Shannon. Referee talking to Mushal. Look at that header from Shannon. Rising as it hit his head. to England players, cursing the luck. They've just got to keep trying. Dana, well in by Bell, and Dana chicken out of that. Hunter, 9 minutes to go to half-time. Chivers, Peters, that could well be a pass for Hughes by Kasperjak. Lance Mikhaevic, Bell! But another ooh. Polish team must be praying for half-time. And England want to get one before them. Well played, Colin Bell. The punch, Madeley. And another corner. And the Poles now forced to bring back. Oh, by the Muskie. Orlato is just a little bit away. 2 minutes to half-time. Goalkeeper coming an awful long way again. I can't think why, because he looks nothing like as good there as he does on his line. Tomaszewski. 25 years old, some people thought to be one of the weak links. But he's looked it when he's come for the crosses, but he's made two good stops. Godoka. hasn't lost him. Him being Maitley. Smikiewicz. Kasperzak. Szymanowski. A rare excursion for the Poles after being penned in their own end for a long time. Good turn by McFarland. Bell, Shannon. Bell's having a good match. Chivers. Seconds running out on the first half. Here's Peters. Clark. Shannon. They got a man over then. Good cross by Clark. Shannon's header tipped over by Tomaszewski. Here's Bell. Chivers. And dangerous kicking against Chivers. Mouchard is the player down. And the half-time whistle goes with the scoreline that England didn't want. 0-0 is the situation, in spite of all the pressure, which produced 14 corners. England go to the dressing room knowing that they've given all they could, but as yet they haven't broken down this Polish defence. Remaining, and England have got to keep going as they've kept going, with perhaps a greater use of the width of the field. There was a tendency to bunch a little bit when you're trying so desperately for a goal. Norman Hunter, a good solid challenge on Smikiewicz. Nicely given and nicely received. Good header. Shannon, fouled by Szymanowski. And the Poles predictably calling back Lato and Domarski. Five in the wall at the moment. Chivers and McFarland on the left side, and the wall to go further back. Clark is outright as we look. McFarland and Chivers left. And here's Hunter. That went off the wall for a corner. We've got to work out something from these set pieces. Curry. Goalkeeper a little bit lucky because Shannon leapt in front of him. Godoka. Michal. Bozatsky. The back pass is blocked. Heard it coolly to Gorgon. He took too long. Now here's Chivers. And Curry. And another one goes begging. That was two on one then. Here's Chivers. Curry number seven to his left. He could have gone perhaps half a yard further forward, I don't know, but the shot wide. So Ralph Ramsey has often talked about making the chances but not putting them away. Tonight, one at least has got to go away. Dana. Szymanowski. Godoka. Smikiewicz. Bell. Clark. Shannon right, Chivers left. Shannon cutting into the middle. Well taken by the keeper. And a free kick has been given against Cork. Chivers deciding to go for the line, pulled it back but not wide enough, and the keeper hugged it well. And Clark made contact, but it didn't look too terrible. And the referee obviously agreed with my assessment. But he wasn't as badly hurt as he was trying to suggest, Tomaszewski. That's Kalinowski who got to his feet then, the substitute goalkeeper. Bell blocked by the referee, but he did knock one on for England in the first half. Damaski, Kadoka, that's Shilton's. Hunter, trusty left foot. Madeley, Bell. Fine ball by Bell, who's having a very, very good match. Hughes, Curry. Why did he punch? Here's Shannon. It's side netting. The goalkeeper could have paid for that. There was no need to punch. Hughes playing it square for Curry, hit it true, the goalkeeper punching when he might have held or put over. Shannon shot, side netting. Foul by Hughes on Damaski. Take it, plays for Wisła Kraków. Szmigiewicz, Bedoka, four in the middle, two forward. Farland after the header, getting the return. Here's Clark, took that away beautifully from Bulzatski. Hunter. Bell. Madeley. Kasper Jack between him and Curry, but he still finds him. Four England players waiting and wait in vain. Hunter's got to make that. And he's lost it. Kadoka is inside McFarland. Hughes trying to get back goal side. Damaski coming up square, number 10. And it's there! Hunter had to make that challenge and he didn't succeed. And Damaski has scored. Kept his head very well to find Damaski, Lato did. And the shot going under Shilton's dive. And England in terrible trouble. One-nil to the Poles, and England have now got the score too. Curry with the throw, leaving it instead for Chivers. Peters. Won't count, the whistle has gone. And Shannon sums it up superbly. But the whistle had certainly gone. Dennis allowed to go on. Right foot challenge on both occasions by Hunter. is Musial. Now Shannon. He's got Clark left. Brought down by Gorgon, but he went the wrong way from England's point of view. Now Peters. That's inside, surely. That is inside that happened. Yes, it is. A penalty. A penalty's been given. Peters, it's definitely inside the box. Right on the edge, maybe, but it was inside. Musial charging Peters off the ball, and a penalty has been given. And Alan Clark, who scored on his debut against Czechoslovakia in the World Cup, has got to put this one away. Clark against Tomaszewski, and England are praying. Goalkeeper starting to go to his right, comes back. In fact, he moved an awful lot and goes the wrong way in the end. And England are alive again. Hunter and Lato. Hughes. Dana, been all the time literally in the middle of the field, nearly all the time. Musial. Dana, too slow. England will be happy about that. Hunter. Hughes up left side, number three, Szymanowski's header. Throw to Poland. Bolzacki. Hunter. Well threaded through. Peters. Shannon, Peters, goalkeeper just got a touch. Played by Maidley. Bell, defender hesitated, Shannon, Chivers, Szymanowski it was who got at it, here's Clark. And the goalkeeper clearing with his feet. Hughes. It's on the right, but he's given it away. And only two back for England, and a line of five coming forward for Poland. Here's Lato, the little man. But thank heaven it's run away from him for a second. Give you nightmares every time they break. Damaski not making that. McFarland. Hunter. Oh, that's a great ball. Peters. Hunter again, right foot. Bell. Maidley. Gadocka. Damaski, the player down. Hughes, still Hughes, not now, and Lato poised all the time just inside his own half to break, number seven, moving into the middle now. Smikiewicz to the right of Dana. And Damaski still in trouble. Referee doesn't want to know. Hunter. Curry. Play on, says the referee. Shannon, spite of Casper Jack's kicking, is Clark. Shannon, Casper Jack really kicking at his ankles. Clark's header over the top. Hunter that time covering McFarland. Given away by Hughes, here's Gadocka. Smikiewicz to his right, Dana further over. This is Domarski. Musial, Bell, look at that pace that he picked up. Look at that drive as he goes through and fouled by Musial. Surely Colin Bell's best game for England. Really has looked what they used to call a wing half, a man who can get it in the middle of the field and can use it forward. Curry, 9 minutes remaining. Peter's winning in the air, but nobody on the end of it. Domarski, Lato, pace with McFarland, and a free kick, and a warning has got to be given. Look at the pained expression on McFarland, that Lato was absolutely clear, and that would have been good night, nurse. England pushing up, but at times they are frighteningly exposed. Four in the wall for the free kick. And Dana to take it. Haven't seen Gadocka take a free kick yet. He's the best bender in the side. Hunter. Is Bell. The free kick against Casper Jack. Maidley. Bell. Curry. Pull back, but still goes on. Shannon. And away by Smikiewicz from Chivers. Little man Lato again. And nobody in the middle. Lato, Hunter trying to cut down the area. Domarski is in the box. Here's Gadocka. Not a good ball, fortunately for England. Bell. England trying in everything by the kitchen sink. Here's Hughes. 7 minutes. Will that be a lucky number? Not for Bell. Domarski. And no flag is up. Here's Lato. They were looking for the offside, just a touch then from Chilton. Still Lato. Here's Dana. Domarski slipping. Casper Jack. And we breathe again. But the whole England side stopped, expecting Lato to be given offside. And there he is. And Kevin Hector going to win his first cap in the last minute and a bit of England's World Cup match. And they've got a score in that time. England's 24th cap in their 28th match. And Chivers is going off. The roar of the crowd, but it's surely too late to expect Hector to produce a miracle. He's now only got a minute plus injury and stoppage time, and he might not even see the ball. Offside against Lato. Hunter. Hector out to the left. Peters played that beautifully to Hughes. Here's Hector. And a useful low cross too. McFarland, and Hector wants it again. He'll go down in history if he can pull this out for England. Hughes, corner. And the ball boy's got a run. Curry coming to take it, but he hasn't been the most successful at corners. Hector on the line. And we move into injury and stoppage time. And off the line! And put past! Off the line in the melee. The goalkeeper got the wrong side. And it was blocked on the line by Szymanowski. He's done it twice in the match. We've had 30 seconds of injury time. McFarland, Bell, Madeley, Hughes, Curry. Peters is underneath it. Here's Bell. Will it come down? Off the line again by Bozanski. It just will not go. We've had now a minute of injury time. Lotto inquiring of the referee how much longer. And the throw was a foul one. Being asked by England players to take off time for time wasting. The Poles wanting to blow the final whistle. Chiloro checking his watch. And the final whistle, and England are out of the World Cup. One won the situation. The end of an era. Sir Alf Ramsey congratulates the Polish doctor. The one breakaway, stabbing England in the heart and taking them out of the World Cup. The Poles, they were written off when they lost at Cardiff, but they're going on to West Germany. The end of an era here at Wembley, because England are out of the World Cup. Beaten in truth by a breakaway goal scored by Damaski in the 57th minute. Clark equalised from the penalty spot after 64, but England, try as they could not drive home the vital second goal. Szymanowski cleared off the line once, Bolzacki on another occasion, but England, so sad, are out of this World Cup.